Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, Using Bibles. Hi, and welcome again to another episode of the ProPresenter Show. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. I'm your host. So, I thought that I had released a tutorial like a couple of months ago on Bibles. Someone asked me a question about it. I said, oh, okay, I'll just go look. I hadn't released it. Now, what I've done is I've done a lot of webinars on it. I've done a lot of live classes about it with my members of Church Tech U, but I hadn't released a pre-recorded video. So, sorry about that, and today we're going to do just that. So, let's head over to my computer and take a look. So, here we are in ProPresenter 7, and the first thing you need to do is go into Bibles. It's right up here. If you don't see it, I do want to say go into Preferences and look at this checkbox right here. Show House of Worship Integrations. Make sure that's checked, because if it's unchecked, notice Bibles went away and so did the CCLI information. Just a couple of things like that disappear. So, check it, should be right there. Okay, now we're going to go into Bibles. This is actually really simple to do, and I want to give you a couple of highlights about it. So let's say that you want to do a search for a Bible verse. This is my non-serious life verse, Acts 26:24. And I'm sure that it was very serious when it happened to the Apostle Paul, but I was studying for a test when I was in college, and the campus minister told me about this verse, and it was just hilarious. So I had just said, man, all this studying is driving me crazy. He said, that's in the Bible. I said, really? He said, yeah, look up Acts 26:24. So that is here. So you can't read that, and there's a reason for that. First, let's go into options, and let's change the theme. I had a theme that was set for the longest verse in the Bible in Esther, and you'll notice that it's very illegible. So we're going to just scroll down here. I think it is under, I thought it was scripture, nope, let's see where I put this, here we go, multiple Bible translations. So I'm going to select that one. There we go. And this is one that I made myself. It's basically got places for two different scriptures and two different citations. So you'll notice I've got some other options in here. I can show verse numbers, break on new verse, display translation, you know, a lot of different stuff here. So just choose the appropriate thing that you want and import library. That's where you're going to import scripture into if you save it, if you're not just displaying it immediately. So we're going to get out of that. Now you can read this. So, first thing, you need to select your translation. The only reason I chose World English Bible is it was free. So, no theological anything. That's just the only reason I chose that. So, you need to decide where you're going to put your verse. So, if we see here, it has all the text boxes listed, and it shows a graphical representation of where they are. So let's put scripture 1 in scripture 1. Now let's put the reference in citation one. And I just made a theme. I've got another tutorial on how to make themes, so you can check that. But basically, to make sure that they had that label, I changed the label on each of the text boxes. So just to make it nice and simple, scripture one is in scripture one, citation one is in citation one. And if you only need one translation of the Bible, you're done. You can just click on that if you want, or you can save it. And there are three choices. Save as a presentation, saves it as its own little mini document. Copy to selected presentation, copies it into whichever document, you know, song, sermon notes, whatever you have selected right now. Copy to playlist, copies it, it saves it as a presentation and doesn't just put it in the library like the first one does. It saves it into a particular presentation as its own thing. So that's the difference between the three. Let's save this to playlist. I believe I'm on this playlist. So we'll put it there. Yep, see, showed up right there. Easy peasy. Now the real power of Pro 7 comes in when you have multiple translations. It's possible to kind of do something like this in Pro 6, but it's more steps. Here's how you do it in Pro 7. You click on the plus button here, and if I was doing this week in and week out, I'd click don't show again. But since I'm showing it to you, and I show it to other people when I'm doing training, I leave that on and I just click OK. So what that says is we're only going to put one verse up at a time. We're not going to put several verses because we've got more than one translation and it's just not going to work. So now let's choose our friend King James. Again, no other reason, but same reason as I have these four, is they are free with ProPresenter. And I'm not actually presenting scripture for this. So now I need to choose the text box that I want the verse to go in. There. Now I need to choose the text box I want the reference to go in. There. Now, I can do the exact same thing. I can save as and go there. Or one thing that you might want to do is choose none for one of these so that you have the citation just in a single place. Up to you. Just thought that I'd throw that out. But you can have multiple translations. You can only add as many as you have translations downloaded onto ProPresenter. So I have five translations. I can do five. But as you look right here, that's going to get really crowded really fast. So probably, unless you've got a really wide screen or you've got a really tall screen, chances are you're probably going to want to keep it to three, maybe four max, because it's going to get really crowded really fast. So, and notice that my theme, since it only has four text boxes, I'm out of text boxes except this citation text box that I showed earlier. And you'll notice that I made that too small to actually have a verse there. So I'm going to go back to none, and I'm going to get rid of that. And so that's how you can do it. A couple of circumstances where you might want to do it. If your pastor is comparing different translations, great use case for it. Another use case, though, is what if you've got a bilingual church? You could have the English and the Spanish, for example. And you could even, in your theme, change the color of each one of these so that, you know, they stand out a little bit, maybe use a different font. Whatever you want to do. So that is how you do Bible translations in ProPresenter 5. Or, not ProPresenter 5, ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, I bet you'd like Church Tech U, my online Church Tech training community. So head over to churchtechu.com, and there you can learn more about it. Join my mailing list over there and get a free copy of my keyboard shortcuts for Pro 6 and Pro 7 so that you can maximize your time in creating presentations. And you'll be some of the first to know about the upcoming things that I've got planned, including, as I'm recording this, later this week I'm going to do a Pro 7 Quick Start Challenge. But unless you're watching that towards the end of July 2020, you've already missed that, but there's more exciting stuff coming. So, by all means, get a hold of that, join the newsletter, and you can find out more about all that. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.